Welcome to Your Need to Know. I'm your host, Katherine Reed, and today we're going to be talking with the Executive Director of Computer Corps, Lynn O'Connell. Welcome. So thank you so much for joining me, Lynn.
Thank you, Katherine. We're delighted to be here today.
So Computer Corps has been around in Northern Virginia for quite a long time, and you guys provide an array of services that maybe our viewers have not heard about. So why don't you start at the beginning of how Computer Corps came to be here and walk us a little bit through your evolution of where you started from and where you are now.
Exactly. I always jokingly say Computer Corps is one of the hidden gems of Northern Virginia. Back in 1999, a young woman named Deb Repke moved here from Iowa. She was working for a defense contractor and had been a computer IT administrator at her college before relocating to DC. At her church, they had an open wing during the week, which was only used for Sunday school on Sundays. And so she came up with the concept, wouldn't it be great to help adults learn about computer skills? It was 1999, right, and you needed to have some computer skills, she thought. So she began Computer Corps that year. The first graduating class had 3 students. And then as time went on, the program gained recognition and began to grow. By about 2006, the program was up to about 48 students in each graduating class. Then in 2007, the board of directors of Computer Corps began to look at the concept, there may be more to this that we're doing than simply computer literacy. Maybe we should reach further and make our focus workforce development, which they did. And at that point, Computer Corps' mission became to provide low-income adults with technological and professional skills to help them achieve career aspirations. Our tagline is building careers in community, because what we've learned is when we bring the adults together in a classroom, 12 students and then 4 to 6 volunteer instructors as well, we find that not only do they gain computer skills, but they also gain confidence on the computer, confidence in interacting with other diverse people and nationalities. They also gain competency and workforce readiness skills, and they build a support system, a community of people that they can network with and help them get new jobs. Well, and it works.
And relationships are important. So you have a cohort of students. So,
exactly.
You know, and that, I think a lot of programs, from leadership programs to other kinds of programs, when you have a cohort of students, those relationships naturally evolve, and that helps later on when you're out in the workforce and you're moving around. So I'm assuming when you help people to get ready for the workforce, you're also helping them to try to find that entry position that moves them into maybe a new career for them. Can you talk a little bit about
Sometimes,
how you do that?
One of CORE's niches is that we're there to serve any low-income adult who's highly motivated to get a job or a better job. So in one cohort of 12, we have had before a Pakistani woman with a 5th grade education from Pakistan and an aerospace engineer with a PhD from Ethiopia, all in the same class.
Wow.
But what I've learned, and I did not expect this when I came to CORE, I thought when I came in 2008, by 2010, we wouldn't need to be teaching computer skills.
Right, everybody would know.
Trust me, we do. But what we learned is, no matter what your level of education or no matter what your former pay, we have individuals come into our program who came to us before they lost their jobs with salaries nearly $300,000.
Right.
Then they'd been unemployed for 5 or 6 years and couldn't get back in the workforce. So it's a leveler. So folks come in and we work with them to help them look at their skill set and their goals and their requirements and help them find a job and a career pathway and an educational pathway that works for them.
So how do you find the students, or how do the students find you?
We're very lucky at Computer Corps as we enter now approaching our 20th year, in that it's 90% to 95% alumni referrals. Our graduates have tended to be some of our biggest supporters and ambassadors. For 2016, 87% of our graduates made one or more financial contributions to Computer Corps.
Wow.
We find, and you'll be introduced to Evelyn shortly, we tend to have 10 to 15 who come back as volunteer instructors the term after they graduate.
So that would be my next question, is where do you find your instructors? And you've just answered part of that, is your alumni.
It's amazing. We have 284 active volunteers, and then other times periodic volunteers like yourself.
Right, I have yes, I have done that. And that's because you came to the City of Fairfax Rotary Club.
That's right.
And did a presentation,
right.
And you said, tonight we have, it's role playing for job interviews, and was there anybody in the Rotary Club? And I happened to be visiting that Rotary Club.
That's right.
But I happened to be visiting. I'm like, yeah, I can actually do that. And so two members, we came and actually sat down and went through the role playing of helping people practice for job interviews.
So anyway, I am shocked to tell you that we actually don't have a problem getting volunteers. Sometimes it's a problem to match them. I think it's because our other niche, beyond serving any adult in need of help with jobs, is that we are a community-based, volunteer-driven nonprofit. Volunteer-driven is a little different in the sense that most of our volunteer opportunities are skills-based, and then when the volunteers come to us, they have an opportunity to have authority and have control over their
area of expertise. Right.
And so they love that. I mean, it's a certain type of volunteer. Not everyone wants that. I myself sometimes just want to go to the food bank and give food out for 2 hours and come home. But our volunteers typically want authority and responsibility and challenges. Our average volunteer retention rate is 3 years. We have a number of volunteers who've been in their positions longer than I've been with CORE, which is nearly a decade.
See, and that is a testament to not only how it works for your students, but how it works for your volunteers, which is really important. You want to provide the right opportunity so it's a good fit and the volunteer has a really good experience.
And with our students, I jokingly say it's all consenting adults. All of our volunteers, all of our students come because they really are passionate and highly motivated to do what we're doing.
So how do you collaborate with other organizations? I mean, there's got to be a lot of nonprofits who are looking at what you do saying, oh, the people we serve could so use what you're offering.
Partnerships is what we're all about. It's what has allowed us to expand from, in 2008, one site to 7 sites where we have our full 18-week program, and then a myriad of sites throughout Northern Virginia where we do short courses. We're overwhelmed with requests, quite honestly. We don't have the capacity to meet all the needs for everyone. But we do tend to try to partner with organizations where if they have a space with a bit of Wi-Fi, or we can bring in a router, and they have clients in need and highly motivated for job seeking, then we actually can go in. It's almost like a classroom or a project in a box. We can go in with our IT equipment, so we bring all the computers, cables, the server. We come in with our curriculum, we come in with our volunteers, and we can run the program on site at their location, which also overcomes barriers of transportation,
child
care.
That's so key.
So the other is fear issues.
Right. So if somebody, and you talked about capacity, and there are things that are needed for capacity building, and one of them is resources,
and
the main resource being money. But I would assume that the other resource is computer equipment, too.
Exactly. Now, yes, charitable contributions. Computer CORE relies entirely on charitable contributions for our support, so that's very important. But yes, beyond that, every day we need donations of desktop computers for our classrooms, laptops, because we also try to give every student in need a home laptop to keep.
That's great. We also
need flash drives. We need binders. So any of that, and it's an ongoing. Currently, we serve about 260 students annually.
Right.
So we have a chronic need for those items.
Well, that's good for people to know, because there are lots of ways for people to support the work that you're doing. And if we're going to help to expand the work that you're doing, then we need to talk about capacity building, because I can imagine, to your point, bringing the classes to where the students are, transportation really is a problem, and child care really is a problem. So if other organizations at this point even wanted to partner with you, you would have to figure out how to put all of these things in place.
Exactly. So the donations really matter. So watchers are thinking about where they work, where they go to church, about their Rotary clubs, could they do a drive or gather together any sort of computers, laptops, flash drives, binders, we'd love to have them.
You know, and I'm thinking too, there are a lot of offices that do clean outs and they get rid of things like binders because nobody,
exactly.
You know, like my husband's law firm, they scan all the documents. Yeah. And so there's a point at which if you're gonna digitize everything, don't throw out those binders. That's
exactly.
One. And the same with computer equipment. If you're upgrading your computer equipment at your office, people need to think to themselves, what can we do with this old computer equipment? How about finding an organization like yours where it can be refurbished and rehabbed and put into place.
And we are a Microsoft certified refurbisher, so we have volunteers of course, who are certified to wipe clean the machines and totally refurbish them. We have a partnership with Microsoft, so we get discounted Windows licenses as well as Microsoft Office to put on the computer desktops and the laptops we give to the students.
And the laptops are so key too. What good does it do you to learn something and then go home and have nothing on which to practice or to actually use what you learned in class?
And the other brilliant part of it is we put, again, exactly what they're using in the classroom on their laptops. So they really have an ability to practice. It also gives them the ability, of course, when they're not in class, to be applying for jobs,
right,
tweaking the resume,
right,
sending emails and follow-up email thank yous after job interviews.
Things like that. And I would assume that, too, that this really benefits the whole family if we're talking about adults who are in homes with children where there isn't a computer. So
absolutely. And it also, the role modeling. Most right. of this, our adult students will say, you know, I love it when my children see me studying. And our graduations, oh my goodness. At our graduations, they all bring their children. And they all dress up in their best clothes. And then we have the graduation ceremony. And they go up on stage. And they get their certificate. And everyone claps. And there's hundreds of photos. It really sets a great model for their students.
It does. And it sets the stage, too, for a transformation and a transition into the next stage and the next chapter. And so it's interesting to me that your graduates are coming back as volunteers. I know we're going to talk to Evelyn
right.
in a few minutes. But, you know, what would you say to people who are considering whether this is a really good investment of their time, assuming that people's real hurdle is how do I find the time if I'm working three jobs and I have to take a bus to get there?
I will say it's not for everyone. I mean, you have to decide. But if you're looking for substantive, skills-based volunteering, and you truly want to feel like you're making an impact and see that impact, come in. I mean, when the students run into the instructors later or email them or come back and visit and say, I got that job, or guess what, I got that promotion, or guess what, I just graduated from UVA.
Wow.
You know, what can you do that's more powerful and more meaningful? And you're not just changing one life, you're also changing the lives probably of the children and the grandchildren. And you know what our volunteers say?
What?
They get more out of it than the students.
You know, that is so true. And I've heard that in hosting the show for lots of organizations, that's exactly what I hear. That people are like, this is the most important, meaningful work I've ever done, aside from whatever their career was. And so I appreciate you joining us, Lynn. This has been very informative. Please join us after the break when we're going to be talking with Evelyn Woodard.
Did you know parking over tall, dry grass can spark a wildfire?
Only you can prevent wildfires.
Your son wants to get a cat, but you're allergic. Do you A, prepare yourself, B, make the best of it,
C squared equals 25.
Good job!
Or C, find a loophole. When it comes to parenting, there are no perfect answers, but that's okay, because you don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. Teens in foster care will love you just the same.
Hey, did you know 2.4 million loving cats and dogs in shelters and rescues need our help to find a home? Let's go to the shelterpetproject.org and meet a few who are in a shelter near you. Harlow. Oh, she's one great listener who loves to hear all your stories. My kind of cat. Cerulo. Is a sweet, goofy boy who's eager to please. Sounds just like another dog I know. So go to the shelterpetproject.org, search your local shelters and rescues, and go for a cuddle with your next best friend. Adopt.
Welcome back to Your Need to Know. I'm your host, Katherine Reed, and today we're talking with Computer Corps, which is an organization that does workforce development through computer training. And joining me in this segment is Evelyn Woodard, who is both a graduate of Computer Corps and is now a volunteer instructor. Thank you for being here, Evelyn.
Thank you so much for having me.
So tell us a little bit about how you found Computer Corps, what made you decide to invest your time mm-hmm. in going through the program, and how that has impacted you and influenced your decision to then become an instructor?
Well, I always knew that I wanted to go back to school. I am a high school graduate, and I decided that I wanted to start last year, but I knew that I had to have some computer skills, and my computer skills were very basic. So I was talking to my brother one night, and I said, I need to go back to school, but I'm scared to go to college because I don't have computer skills. So he actually was a volunteer for Computer Corps, I believe, 2 years.
Wow.
And he said to me, I'll send you all the information, you need to call them. And he gave me, he told me basically what I needed to do. So I called, and immediately I fell in love with the program. And I knew it was gonna be hard because I work full time. So I decided that I would do I went to school on Tuesdays and Thursdays from 7 to 10, and I got off at 6 o'clock. So basically I had to go home, change, eat something, and go to school.
How many weeks? So that's 2 nights a week for how many weeks?
I want to say 18
weeks. 18 weeks, that was the 18-week program.
Yeah.
So that's a big commitment.
Yes, it is a big commitment. It's hard work, it's tiring, but I knew that I wanted to do this to get to my goal. So when I started with Computer Corps, it was very overwhelming. I remember my first day looking at the computer and open up Word, and I was overwhelmed. I didn't know what to do.
Or where to start, and it looks unfamiliar, right?
Very. So my classmate, the person that sat next to me, we looked at each other and we were like, oh, we can do this. We're like, we're gonna take it one step at a time, we can do this. And that's how I started. And throughout the weeks, like I said, it was very hard, but I learned a lot. Not only did I learn how to type, because I used to type 14 words per minute.
Right.
And then my instructor taught me how to type. I know how to type now. I know how to do so many things on Word, Excel, and PowerPoint. And my decision to go back as an instructor is because I feel so passionate about this program, because I learned a lot. And I see the people that are there is so, like right now when I'm being an instructor, people are having such a hard time with it, and I just tell them just stick with it. Just one day at a time, you know, and I help them out, and they believe in me because I tell them, you know, I used to be here, I used to be in your shoes. And then when I tell them my story, they believe in me, you know, and when I show them, you know, what I've learned, you know, it just gets them motivated to keep going.
You know, I'm sure that is a very compelling story. First of all, that you were working full time, that you made this commitment for 18 weeks, mm-hmm. that you went from being intimidated to now being an instructor in their class. That's a long way to come.
It is.
And I'm sure that is very inspiring for people to think, she used to sit here and she was scared, and now she's at the front of the room telling me I shouldn't be scared.
Yes. There were some nights that I just shook my head, and I just kept telling myself, I don't know how I'm gonna learn this. I don't know. It was so foreign. Everything was just so foreign to me, you know, and little by little, I learned it. I learned it, you know, and now this is what I'm telling the students. Don't give up. You can do this. You can get a better job, because everywhere you go, you need computer skills nowadays. I was looking for a new job on the internet, and I was actually on Craigslist, and every single posting, I want to say 99% of the postings, they want you to know computer. They
right.
want
they
you to have
to,
skills.
Especially things like Excel or Microsoft Word, what people consider basic computer literacy, really.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
But you know, accomplishing that, graduating, actually does give you a certain amount of confidence to then go on and take other important steps, like looking for another job.
Yes, and that's actually what I did. I think I was in class. I think I was in Computer Corps for maybe a month when I decided that I wanted to look for a new job. So one of my instructors, the career development instructor, she helped me with my resume. She looked at my resume, she told me what I needed to change, what I needed to add, and that motivated me to get a new job, because the past job that I was at, I wasn't very happy with it. So what I did is I got my resume ready, and I started sending it out to different companies, and I want to say within one day, I got a call, and I went to an interview, and I got the job.
See, that's amazing how confidence in one area spills over and suddenly the thing that you had been reluctant to do, you did, and it was like, boom, and it worked.
And it was all because of her. She helped me. She gave me that confidence. She told me, you can do this. You want a better job, you can do this, you know. So I got the job, and I immediately told my new boss, I said to her, I need to be out of work early on Tuesdays and Thursdays because I'm taking this class. And she said, okay. She asked me what it was about, and I explained it to her. And then she said, okay, great, no problem, you can do that. You know, once I finished the class, I came back to her, and I said, look, I finished my class. And I showed her my certificate, and she was very, very proud of me. And then 2 days later, she came back to me, and she sat me down, and she said, I'm really proud of you. I feel like you're a great asset to my company. And she gave me a raise.
How about that?
Yeah.
You know, you are exactly the kind of employee that every business is looking for, and that is a self-motivated, committed person who sets a goal and achieves it, and it benefited not only you, but it benefited your employer too.
Yes.
So what a wonderful thing that your employer actually recognized that in a substantive way with a raise.
Yes.
That is
yes,
a fantastic story.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
That should give everybody confidence that's in your classes too.
Yes.
So talk a little bit about who some of the typical students are in your classes. I mean, you know, do you see similarities about who is coming to the classes?
Yes, I do. Actually, I see a lot of people with like so much potential, great skills. Like some of the people that are in there, they've have degrees in their countries, and then they come to here, you know, for a better life, and they just want to learn. They know that they need this computer skills, and they even tell me, they say, I need to learn this so I can get a better job, you know. And I sit there and I talk to them, and they talk to the instructor as well, and then, you know, we help them. These are really good people with great potential.
And that's good to know too, the fact that there are so many motivated people out there who just need encouragement and need resources.
Mm-hmm.
What about things like the cost? Is that prohibitive for people? I mean, as far as the computer core training, you know, are there scholarships? Is there financial aid? How do people manage that financial commitment?
Not quite sure how that works. I know that they have grants that people can apply for, and they'll help them out with books, with computers, with anything that they need. I know that they have that.
So people can apply. So not just applying for the class itself, but you can say, I need a little bit of help, and there are resources.
Right. There are resources. I know that they can get laptops. I know I got a laptop for a very low cost, and it helped me tremendously because I did not own a laptop prior to this class. And I got a laptop, and with that, I used to do work at home.
Right.
So I did homework, I did everything that I needed to do at home, and I still use that laptop as of right now.
That's fantastic. Yes. And I know you've got a lot of different locations too.
Mm-hmm.
Lynn was saying that you have the ability to actually take your classes to on-site to other people.
Mm-hmm.
And so, you know, that intrigues me as well, because you'll need more instructors in order to do that, and it looks like a lot of your you as a graduate came back as a volunteer instructor, and I'm also intrigued by the fact that graduates are the ones who refer people.
Yes.
So your brother, who was an instructor, referred you.
Yes. And I've talked to, and a lot of my friends ask me, or friends of friends ask me, because I always talk about computer career. I learned this, I learned that, I'm now doing this. So a lot of my friends have asked me, well, how did you get in there? And I get the flyers and I give it to them. And I know there was one, I think she enrolled, I'm not sure what site she's in, but I know she's in one of the sites right now. So like they said, it's from past students. That's how we get other students coming in.
And so all of these resources or information is available on www.computercore.org.
Yes.
.org. And so if people are interested in the information or want to print out information to share with somebody else, that would be the best way to go about it, yes?
Mm-hmm. You can look it up online as well. That's what I did too, just to learn more. My brother sent me a flyer, but I also looked it up online and I read more about it, and it gives you all the information from there.
So how you go forward?
Yes.
And as far as ages, does the age ranges, or typically, do you have very young people? Do you have older people? Everything in between?
Well, in my class, it was mostly, I know there were people younger than me and older than me. So it's all ages, people
right.
that just want to learn about computers, about programs.
So you're never too old to go back and get these skills.
Right, yes.
And the fact that people are from such a diverse background, you know, how does that work out in the classroom when everybody is speaking other languages as their primary language and English as their second language. Is that a barrier at all, or does everybody figure it out?
No, we figure it out. We all understand each other. There's sometimes, you know, we have to be patient with other students, but it's fine. It works out, you know.
Because computers actually are a universal language, which
yes.
is one of the reasons that you need to learn the skill set, is because computers have no language.
Right.
You just have to learn the steps.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and I do think it's interesting that you've got people with varied backgrounds. Some people who are highly educated in their own countries coming here and lack this fundamental piece, this missing
mm-hmm.
piece to
mm-hmm.
take that next step
mm-hmm.
into another job. And so when people have completed the course, I know that you said that you had an instructor who helped you with your resume. There are other things. I was a volunteer who helped with job interview role playing.
Mm-hmm.
Do you have other kinds of volunteers that do other things like that?
That come in into the program?
Right.
Yes, they do. We have volunteers that come in and do an interview to help people, you know, interview for jobs. So they do that as well, which is very helpful for a lot of us. I know it was for me as well as from my past classmates.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
And it was just your instructor who helped you with your resume. But I'm assuming
yes.
there are probably a lot of people who are willing to do that.
Oh,
for
yes.
people who are like, I'm looking for a job now.
Mm-hmm. And basically, and also, I want to say that if there's something that we don't understand during class, we can also come on Saturdays. There's volunteers that come in on Saturdays from 10 to 12, and they will sit there with you, and they will help you. So we
that's
also
fantastic.
Have that
so
as well.
So that's like Saturday tutoring then
yes.
for the classes?
Yes, that's basically what it is.
And is that a specific location or at all locations?
It's at the Bailey's. The one I used to go to is the Bailey's Crossroads location.
Okay.
That's where I went to for that.
That is fantastic.
Mm-hmm.
Tutoring.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it seems like Computer Corps has thought of everything.
Yes.
So your recommendation to people who want to volunteer or to be a student is to go to the website, I'm sure.
Yes.
But the other thing about advocacy, and you are a wonderful spokesperson, is for people to talk about it.
Yes,
you know,
talk
about it. And you are a wonderful spokesperson. And
Thank you.
I'm sure if people wanted their Rotary Club or their Kiwanis Club or their Garden Club to know more about this program and how they might be able to help, they could reach out for someone who can come and speak to their club. Would
absolutely,
that be right?
Yes,
okay, that's
absolutely.
Bad. Thank you so much, Evelyn,
Thank
for being
you.
Here. I appreciate it. This is what you need to know about Computer Corps.